You can deploy the entire Prometheus monitoring stack using a Helm chart called Kube Prometheus Stack. And in this overview, we're going to break down the entire Prometheus architecture and discuss how all of these different components come together to provide a very powerful monitoring solution. It all starts with the Prometheus operator. The Prometheus operator extends the functionality of Kubernetes because it's a custom controller that watches out for custom resources, and these custom resources essentially tell it what to do. So the Prometheus custom resource in this case is also deployed because it signals the Prometheus operator to create and manage a Prometheus server within the cluster. The Prometheus server is responsible for storing all of the metric data in a time series database. The node exporter extracts system-level metrics such as CPU usage and memory consumption from every single node, from every single machine in your Kubernetes cluster. Kube state metrics is another exporter, but this one collects metrics about the current status and health of Kubernetes resources like pods, deployments, and services. And both of these exporters, node exporters and kube state metrics, they expose metrics at specific endpoints. However, for Prometheus to scrape these metrics, we need to establish a connection between these exporters and the Prometheus server. Service monitors are also custom resources that are deployed to signal the Prometheus operator to reconfigure the Prometheus server and tell it exactly where to find the endpoints it needs to scrape. And so once Prometheus knows where the targets are, it needs to interact with the Kubernetes API to gain access to these services. As Prometheus scrapes metrics from various targets, it stores this data in its internal time series database. And now Grafana is also deployed, and it connects to Prometheus and uses PromQL, Prometheus's query language, to retrieve all of these metrics and create insightful visualizations out of them. And so this setup allows us to monitor both system-level metrics collected by the node exporter and Kubernetes-related metrics collected by the kubestate metrics exporter, and allow us to visualize them in very nice and insightful Grafana dashboards. And we get all of that for free by simply deploying the monitoring stack using the Helm chart Kube Prometheus stack. However, we want to go even further now. We don't want to limit ourselves to just monitoring system-level metrics, as important and essential as that is. We want to also monitor our own applications. So now we can go ahead and deploy our own application. It could be a Flask application if you want. And now you need to instrument that application to expose metrics at a particular path. Then deploy your own service monitor that signals the Prometheus operator to reconfigure Prometheus to discover your application's as metrics endpoint and collect your application's as metrics. In Grafana, you can now create dashboards that visualize these application-specific metrics and monitor your application's performance in real time, similar to how we were monitoring the system-level metrics. And now, finally, collecting and visualizing metrics is essential, but being proactively notified about issues is just as critical. That's why we have the Alertmanager custom resources that signal the Prometheus operator to manage the creation of an Alertmanager instance. The Prometheus Rule custom resource sets conditions for alerts that should be fired, such as when CPU usage reaches a certain level. And so Prometheus receives all of these rules that are defined via the operator, and when it detects that a certain threshold has been reached, it notifies Alertmanager, which sends alerts to the right channels like email, Slack, or PagerDuty based on predefined settings. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this Prometheus overview. If you enjoy my teaching style, make sure to check out our Kubernetes course, and I will see you in the next one.